This is Reform Television, exposing the lies. This is Reform Television, exposing the lies.
Good morning from here and welcome to Sunrise Daily News Report on BTV. My name is Ngozika Chukwu. Here are the news headlines. Anambra election boycott was a huge success. Chicken finished in Ochanja Market ahead of Ofensala Day. Obiano was engaged in vote buying to top scanty election results. The real criminals in Nigeria are not the terrorists, Professor Franzik. Nigerians keep dying while wandering their way to Europe. After losing the mandate of the people, INEC went ahead to declare Willie Obiano winner of Anambra election. And finally, IPOB will sustain election boycott in Biafra land. Now the news in details. The indigenous people of Biafra have applauded the people of Anambra for hearkening to the call for Anambra election boycott. In its congratulatory message, Eba Powerful, the media and publicity secretary of the indigenous people of Biafra, expressed his satisfaction, stressing that the people of Anambra State have shown the whole world that they are the first son of Biafra land, and no doubt about that. There was no election in Anambra State. Everywhere was empty. Both the polling booths and streets were totally deserted, he said. We want to tell the whole world that IPOB, under the leadership of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, gave the order on Anambra State governorship election to prove to civilized nations that we are no more interested in the system of government and her political strategies. The international community and other civilized nations should come for rescue of Biafrans in the Nigerian Islamic government. Chicken finishing Ochanja Market ahead of Ofensala Day. History was made on November 18th, Ofensala Day in Anambra State, when Biafrans went shopping for the great Ofensala Day. Reports from different markets around Onitsha, the commercial city of Anambra State, highlighted the rush for chicken ahead of Ofensala Day. It was reported that as at 4 p.m. on November 17th, there was no more chicken left in the Ochanja Market. Some Biafrans in Onitsha had no other option than to travel across the bridge to buy the chicken for Ofensala. However, Biafrans were reportedly happy to be at home with their families and friends, enjoying Ofensala Day, and many were found in the company of neighbors who joined in the celebration. All through Biafra land, Ofensala Day will remain a memorable day that will be celebrated by generations to come. Obiano engaged in vote buying to top scanty election result. It was seen to have become shameful then to the history of Nigerian politics. Vote buying was moved to another level when Biafran decided to boycott the Anambra election. Governor Willie Obiano, who had earlier boasted that he was going to sweep through to win the election, had found himself in a terrible mess when Biafran deserted the polling unit. He had to rely on scanty vote from strangers whom his agent fought hard to lobby for Obiano to have a few votes. Observers expressed concern over the level of open vote buying that characterized the November 18th election. Dr. Chima Amadi, the executive director of ISDMG, noted that the widespread reports from field observers indicating vote buying and inducement of voters and security agencies by political parties and their agents during the exercise. Reports from our observers in the field on the widespread open selling of votes by citizens cast a major slur on the integrity of the vote. The trend of vote buying, which has become a major feature of recent election, suddenly repeated itself in Anambra. Also, Mr. Clement Wankwa, convener of Nigerian Civil Society Situation Room, in his interim report also noted buying and selling of votes by political parties and electorate during the election. Situation Room is also disappointed with political leaders in the state whose conduct, courage and disposition encourage blatant buying and selling of votes to their citizens. This emerging impunity of vote buying appears to be a dangerous trend in our elections and needs to be addressed urgently, he said. It was observed that across the state, that voting caucuses were positioned in ways that compromise the secrecy of voting. There was no standard or consistency with regard to setting up the polling units, Wankwa said. However, BTV correspondents who were out to monitor situations captured most of the polling units scanty with INEC officials and security agents almost idle. At this moment, we'll be going on a break. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Where people are, don't want to vote. You can see this market is empty because of what is happening. So we need our own freedom. So thank God for that.
Okay, you wanted the reason why you don't want to vote today because you are.
I need the freedom.
Okay, you need freedom.
Yeah.
And that is the reason why you decide to come out and sell in the little market here.
Yeah.
Okay. So tell us your name, please.
My name is Shinonso Jimobi.
Okay, from Newi here.
Yeah.
Oh, that is very good. Thank you for making your place right. Thank you very much.
Welcome back. Still on the news. The real criminals in Nigeria are not the terrorists, Professor Frank Zeck. Professors all over the world are beginning to dig deep into the problem with Nigeria. In the recent discoveries, the foreign professor, Professor Frank Zeck, has come up with clear facts why Nigeria remained a failed state. According to him, there is a whole body of research that when people grow up in an environment where people are poor, no healthy food, no job, once the mother and father live there, the offspring will have antisocial effects from the very beginning. Research showed that if the mother and the father suffered hunger at the time they met the baby such that during pregnancy, they did not have enough food for the fetus, this can predispose the offspring to this personality trait. The conclusion can be that antisocial characteristics may be understood as a form of environmental adaptation so that exposure to malnutrition, to hunger during the formation of the baby can have impact on sex determination. This means that in this situation, more boys are born than girls because the brain development predisposes these people to the so-called antisocial behaviors like to have food, you have to kill or steal. Even terrorists around the world tend to come from poor countries, just fight for their people. So, if you want to build a peaceful society, the atmosphere must be conducive. The real criminal or sycophant is not a terrorist. The real criminal is a guy who presides over our people and eats their common wealth without thinking about their welfare. And we have many criminals leading the people in many parts of the world today. They don't care about the people, but these guys you call bad guys just want to improve their lives and those of their families. So, to build a peaceful society, basic human rights must be respected and government must give the people the basic needs of life. At the moment, there is a huge gap between the poor and the rich in Nigeria. And because of this, the poor always become poorer. What we need is the middle class where everybody has the possibility due to his own capabilities to work up. My father was poor, we had nothing but I had the possibility to go to school and then to do it my own way. This is basic for a peaceful society. Everybody has to pursue his life. He maintained that most Nigerians are sick mentally and must consult professionals to find a remedy. In his words, he said, "Let me tell you also, mental illness does not come from God and this is a problem in Nigeria. In Nigeria, those who have mental illness go to church for remedy because they think they have offended God. But that is not true. It is a problem of the society and government plays a role. When you bring people with mental illness to the church, you don't really help them. You make their situation even worse. We have good medication to treat acute forms of psychosis. The acute forms are in countries like Nigeria more often than in Europe. Religion and psychosis or mental illness do not go together. Religion cannot bring solution to mental health. It can only help the family, giving them encouragement but not healing the patient. Religion is like people coming together, praying together, eating together. This should remain, but it should not be used to cure sick people because it does not work. Consequently, more professional reports could surface from other parts of the world to save millions of Nigerians who are sick without knowing it. Nigerians keep dying while wandering their ways to Europe. In what looks like continuous sad stories that has become part of the history of Nigeria, young people have continued to die while wandering their way to Europe. 26 Nigerian ladies were already dead and could not make it alive to Italy. Reports from Italy has it that the coffins of 26 young children lie in state in the winter sunshine in a cemetery in southern Italy where a bishop and imam read prayers for the all-female victims. People pay their respect to 26 teenage migrant girls found dead in the Mediterranean in early November during the inter-religious funeral service at the cemetery of Salerno, southern Italy on November 17, 2017. The bodies of the victims were found floating in the water by a Spanish military ship and brought to Italy on November 3rd after two separate rescue operations. According to reports, the Mediterranean claimed at least 60 other lives in the fatal accident off Libya 15 days ago. But their bodies sank. Most of the new graves in Salerno, south of Naples, were marked by number only. The autopsies show these were girls and women aged between 13 and 20 years old. But only two of them have been identified so far. Marian Shaka and Osato Osaro, they are both 20. Shaka was Christian, her husband identified her body. Osaro was Muslim and it is up to her brother to carry out the same task. The men, both survivors, stand a little apart from the other mourners. Osato's brother, 18, left home with his sister at the start of the year and spent 6 nightmarish months in crisis hit Libya. Where you get shot for nothing. The pair of them attempted the doomed crossing to Europe. My sister was so good. My mother was very proud of her. Beside him, Maya's husband, a bright pink cap on his head, remains silent. It could be noted that young people who die at sea for nothing but a piece of bread is not worth it, says Samba, a 48-year-old Senegalese worker who has been living in Italy for 15 years. Nearly 3,000 men, women, and children have died attempting the perilous crossing since the beginning of the year. Postmortem examination showed almost all the girls and women died of asphyxiation in the water when the inflatable digger they were traveling on sank. One girl suffered a wound to her liver. Two of the dead were pregnant. According to the United Nations, 80% of young Nigerian women arriving in Italy are already in the clutches of prostitution networks or quickly fall under their control. It wasn't clear whether that was the case here. This moment, we'll be going on a break. We'll be right back.
We need peace, we choose freedom. We need peace, we choose freedom. There was a nation living in peace and unity. Hey, there are people with love and harmony. Oh, yeah. They saw greatness rise up to its purity. With another people of different culture, Indian heritage, bias and oppressive. Oh, I see a nation from trigger of Africa, rising with strength and might and power. In due time nobody gonna oppress us, rather you all gonna praise her. With your flag, with your flag, with your flag, with your flag. Oh yeah. Let the tears of our mothers who lost their children be heard. Let the blood of our heroes speak from now till forever. Let the whole wide world know Biafra is our home. Oh yeah, Biafra is our home.
I reminisce way back, 1967. Death toll and the blood couldn't count them even. Mama's screaming, child's killing, pops underground. 2.5 years, over 3 million's gone. Why?
Cause we ask for our freedom, and we're going back to our sovereign kingdom.
They shut us down when we cry, the world say nothing. Sitting back in the crib, watching our suffering. Should I talk about the planes dropping shells like rain? Suka had the first thirst of a hero's blood. Abagana Zobuni Gwei was stronger than flood. But Ojukwu's too strong and fought them off on each other. Thought the bloodshed's gone, then it came again. 2016 and the massacre, it started again. So bloody now, I couldn't cry tears. Blood dripping down my eyes, water in my veins. We died trying to fight the cause and we're trying to break it. It's our freedom, but the world was against us.
Wave your flag over Africa. Welcome people of Biafra. Wave your flag over all the world. See those people of Zion is here.
It is the nation that the Lord has chosen for the people of Zion. It is the nation that the Lord has chosen for the people of Zion.
We need peace, we choose freedom. We need peace, we choose freedom. Let the tears of our mothers who lost their children be heard. Let the blood of our heroes speak from now till forever. Let the whole wide world know Yahshua is our home. I see the rising sun from Africa.
Welcome back, still on the news. After losing the mandate of the people, INEC went ahead to declare Willie Obiano winner of Anambra election. In Anambra, Willie Obiano has returned to rule the people whose mandate he lost on November 18th. IPOB, in reaction to INEC's declaration, said, "Nothing could be further from the truth. Going by INEC's own figures of accredited voters, not up to 10,000 people participated in this keenly contested election involving more than 2.2 million registered voters. This represents only 0.45% of the entire electorate. No civilized society will regard such low number of voters as a credible enough number to sustain a democratic mandate of the office of the governor of a state. Every conscientious and right-thinking person must be appalled at the level of deception and collusion currently going on between the corrupt Nigerian government, her politicians, and some unethical media propaganda machines who are prepared to publish blatant falsehood as part of a wider conspiracy to deny the inevitable fact that IPOB boycott was obeyed by 99% of voters in Anambra State. IPOB rendered the whole exercise meaningless. What this proves is that IPOB is clearly in the majority in Anambra State with 99% of the registered voters abstaining from the polls. It will be fair, therefore, to conclude that the whole electorate in Anambra State heeded the boycott order issued by the Indigenous People of Biafra leader Mazen Nnamdi Kanu," he said. It could be noted that in a highly contested electoral war declared in Anambra State, where troops were deployed in Anambra State like a war front, the Indigenous People of Biafra, having boycotted the election, the polling units were rendered desolate when Biafrans in Anambra refused to give their votes to the same government that had murdered thousands of Biafrans, not minding the will of the people and the failure of the government. After losing the mandate of the people, INEC went ahead to announce Obiano winner of the Anambra election. IPOB will sustain election boycott in Biafra land. The Indigenous People of Biafra has, however, declared that the election boycott shall be sustained in Biafra land. And the press statement signed by the Media Publicity Secretary of the Indigenous People of Biafra, Emma Powerful, he said, "It is very clear to all now that this APC federal government of Nigeria with their collaborators were comprehensively defeated by IPOB yesterday, both in superiority of argument and strategy. Anambra have spoken loud and clear that they want Biafra. We reiterated our demand for a referendum, failure of which will leave IPOB no option than to announce a date at the earliest possible time for a plebiscite to be conducted to settle this issue once and for all. We can assure Asorok and their Southeast leagues that 2019 will be significantly worse than what was experienced yesterday in Anambra State. Nigeria won't be able to produce a president because Southeast and South South will not participate in the next presidential elections. This intellectual battle is one that Nigeria can never ever win. The sooner they come to their senses and realize this inevitability, the better. This moment, we've come to the end of the news for today, but before we go, here are the recap. And Senegal election boycott was a huge success. Chicken finished in Ochanda market ahead of Open Salah Day. Obianọ engaged in vote buying to top scanty election result. The real criminals in Nigeria are not the terrorists, Professor Franzik. Nigerians keep dying while wangling their way to Europe. After losing the mandate of the people, INEC went ahead to declare Willy Obianọ winner of Anambra election, and finally,